you're wrong? What if this has nothing to do with the sword?
What if we're wrong?
The sword will never be used. What if this is the end?
It's just a trick.
It's just a pointless test.
You've been fooled before. You could be fooled again. You never know which way it's going to go.
I want to tell you a story about a god of the Northmen called Baldur. The second son of Odin, he was beautiful, good, and wise. He was fair of feature, he spoke fair words, he gave fair judgments. Light shone from him. Only good things were told of him. Yet he was the first of the gods to die.
Is broken.
There's no way you can fix it.
What do you do now, Senua?
Northmen tell this story about the death of Baldur. It begins with dark dreams. Night after night, Baldur dreams of his own death, and the gods fear for his life. So Baldur's mother makes everything in the world, fire, water, iron, stone, earth, wood, beasts, birds, serpents, poison, sickness, swear and boom, not to harm her son.
She can't. Open the gate.
It's locked. Try harder.
She can't. The gate.
She can't.
She can't.
She will.
She'll find a way. She always finds a way.
Dillian.
There he is.
There he is.
What are you waiting for?
Quick, find a way.
Find him.
Go through
before he disappears.
Dillian, don't lose him.
Way too many times.
You always let him disappear.
Dillian, there he is.
Quick.
Cannot be out.
You are guilty.
Was it worth it? You're still alive and Dillian's dead. He doesn't deserve to be dead. How does that make you feel? Where is he? Where's he gone? We're in the wrong world. He's not here. She's in the east room. He's not in this world. He's in the other one. He's in the other one. He's in the dark world. The dark. The dark world.
The world once seemed so simple. Black and white. Darkness and light. Narrow dividing lines of our own making. Dillian taught her to see further. To peek through the cracks and see the worlds of color stretching away from the gloom. And Senua explored new paths into the unknown.
He's the reason she's alive at all.
Feast and rejoice, and amuse themselves by throwing spears and stones at Baldur, striking at him with sword and axe. But he comes to no harm, whatever they do. The gods never cease to wonder at this great marvel.
Can you remember what love feels like?
But Loki shapes himself into a woman and asks Baldur's mother, "Is it really true that all things promise to keep him safe?" "I did not ask the mistletoe," Baldur's mother confesses. "I thought it was too young." Oh dear. The Northmen tell how the gods mourned Baldur. His body was to be burnt on his ship, but they could not manage to push it into the sea and sent for a giantess to do it. She comes riding a wolf and has vipers for her
rear. Years had passed since she left her father. She trained hard alongside her friend, Dillian. She saw things no one else could. Patterns, shapes, movement. an intuition that made her an exceptional warrior. Friendship turned to love. But the shadow of darkness never let her go, and she was caught between two worlds. That of Zimbel and her past. And Dillian, her future. Two realities tearing at her soul.
She thought she could defy her.
Overcome with grief, the gods send Hermod to ride to Hel and ask Hela to let Baldur return home. All the gods are weeping, he says. Are they? Asks Hela. We shall see as we truly missed. If everything in the world will weep for him, he shall go back to the gods. But if even one thing refuses, Baldur stays with me. The gods send messengers everywhere. Weep for Baldur, weep him out of Hel. And everything wept. Men, beasts, earth, stone, trees, metal, everything. Except for a giantess they find in a cave. Baldur was never my friend, she says. Let Hel keep what she has. The Northmen say that the giantess must have been Loki in disguise.
You are guilty.
Was it worth it? Your love because he believed in you.
Dillian never much cared for the underworld and looked dimly upon the druids like her father, Zinbel. I guess he took after his father, a chieftain who believed nothing he couldn't see, and he happened to be blind. She felt safe in Dillian's arms, learned to see the world through his eyes. Slowly, the darkness that had bound her so tightly began to unravel.
Senua, your father cannot understand your darkness. He cannot see through your eyes. No one can. My own father was born blind. Doesn't have the faintest idea of what the night looks like. The word dark to him means as little as the word light. So someone is afraid of the dark. Should we fix them by taking away their sight? Would you give up the beautiful world that you and only you can see just to be rid of your nightmares? Or is this
killing
the price you pay for the
gift
you have?
They're taking your memories to torture you. They're taking you from the inside.
A gift that makes you feel special in life.
One memory. Every time you remember, it disappears. They're going to take everything. They're not yours anymore. They're going to take everything you have. The memories of ghosts. They belong to the gods
to protect you.
They're eating you from the inside. They want to kill your soul. They want to crush it. They want your body. They want your soul. They want your mind, and they're going to take it.
The memories were yours, but they're the gods now.
Nothing is yours anymore.
Dillian's disappearing with your memories.
say that their all-father, Odin, gave his eye in exchange for a drink from Mimir's well, the Well of Wisdom. In blindness, there can be wisdom. Only by giving can you receive in return. For this reason, I give my life and pass on my stories of the Northmen to you, Senua.
Where am I? I can't see. Who's there?
Can you hear me? I'm right here. Can't you see me?
No. Help me.
Breathe slow.
It's the darkness.
Stay still. Empty your thoughts. Tell me what you feel.
A breeze.
Good. Then there is a way out.
I can't tell where it comes from.
Yes, you can.
The others. The voices. They've gone.
I'm still here.
It's so quiet. So dark.
It's okay. Listen to your own breath. Be aware of everything you hear and feel. Let your senses guide you.
I think I'm somewhere else now. But the breeze has gone.
Use all of your senses. Let the world speak to you. What do you hear?
I hear water.
Go to it.
I've reached the water.
Good. That's your way out. Follow it upstream.
I'm so sorry. I thought I left us all behind.
Don't be sorry. It's not your fault.
He was right. It's inside of him. It won't let me go.
Senua. My father. Look at me. These battles are fought in life. Not the sword. On your count. Prove that you're in a warrior tribe. This is just another battle. You can beat it.
This isn't your bit. You don't have to help me.
I want to. Besides, you are going to be a great warrior one day. We need
my best. There's the water. I can't go
on. I know what you're thinking.
Then look for another way and tell me what you find.
It's not really you.
Seems
there's
a house.
Escaping the past in this place.
she's forced to relive it.
To what end?
What's inside?
Don't be afraid.
It's not following me.
Leave it behind and keep moving forwards.
I think I'm in a house. It stinks. Of death.
The darkness is testing you. But you are in control.
As well.
Don't turn back. You're getting close.
Please. Help me. Please.
Come to the center.
Thank you.
can see you too.
Spend hours, days even, trapped within herself, in the dark.
You see me?
Yes.
Your eyes were open, but you were gone.
And when it finally let her go, she could be anywhere. With no memory of how she got there.
When it comes for me, I have no power over it.
But here, for the first time, someone was there to help.
But I heard your voice. You brought me back.
You found your own way back. All you needed was a little help. A little hope.
Reforged, you will have Odin's blessing to walk a goddess into the halls of Helheim and challenge Hela as an equal.
So Dillion was helping me. And his sword will lead me to him. Like when we first met.
Dillion gave her the strength to pass the warrior trials, and she saw a way out. To leave her past behind, and become a warrior in Dillion's clan.
The sword is tainted by the gods of darkness. Leave it.
No. He left it here. He wants me to take it.
You will pay a price for this.
Years later, with Zinbel's parting words still haunting her, the darkness came back with a vengeance. A plague.
Dillion?
Everyone suffered.
My father was not supposed to die like this.
See it clearly now, Senua. The suffering you've caused.
This is your fault.
You brought this plague to us! You have blood on your hands!
They're coming for you now.
They're coming.
They're coming to get you.
Hold your heavy strike.
Hold it.
Hold the heavy strike.
Hold it.
Unleash the sword.
She's going to die.
No, she isn't.
She needs to focus on that.
The mirror focus is building.
It's building.
She's hurt, this blood.
Shut up!
nowhere to run to.
In the sea of corpses, the corpse waved through itself over the ones I loved. The ship broke up under them. The ship that had sailed from the land of shining fields. Their memorial stone a secret. Come not here in the sun. Come not with a sword. Come not crying over a naked corpse. Come not with disturbed mind.
Do you hear the suffering, Senua? Does your precious gift of sight let you see the souls that rot here in this sea of corpses? Do you feel the blood running cold on your skin? Do you hear their endless cries? Do you smell their putrid wounds? They were once brothers, sisters, and loved ones. And look at what you have done to them. All because you were a coward, because you ran from your curse instead of facing it. When you turned your back on your father, Zimbo, and turned your back on the gods, and let the darkness wreak havoc on your people. Why must they pay for your heresy?
Thank you.
to the gods and let the darkness infest her. But she didn't love you. She escaped the only way she knew how. She gave her life to the gods.
If only you had done the same, the world would have been spared this horror.
It's not too late. She's calling for you. Why don't you join her?
Thank you.
the darkness what once let it swallow your soul and destroy all that you are. Why are you fighting for someone who is already dead? Just look around you. What hope is there for you, even if a soul could be rescued? Do you think he would thank you for what you have done to him, to his friends, to his father?
Gave up on her world to follow in the footsteps of her mother, to go to a place where the darkness couldn't reach her.
Senua, look at me.
Do you hear them? They're calling for me.
We've lost so many. And I've lost my father. I can't lose you.
You said I have blood on my hands.
I didn't say that. You've done nothing wrong.
Zimbal was right. Everyone will suffer.
Zimbal is a fake. He is a hateful, bitter liar. He's poison. And his words still haunt you. Who do you trust? Him? Or me? Do you still believe in me, Senua? In us? Come back to me. Please. This darkness comes.
The hardest battles are fought in the mind. He gave her the sword with which to fight in more ways than one. And she gave him her word, never to surrender. All she needed was a little help.